Greetings, Earthlings. Did I ever show you my blade box? I keep my extras. I have two of these, because I lost one. And don't you know, the day the new one came, I found it. It had rolled behind the microwave. It was missing for, like, forever. I had to keep pulling Mama Nisa and say, Mama Nisa, bring me your thingy for the you-know-what. Anyway, keep my blades to the queasy in here. A workhorse. And, I also keep my Mouli blades in here. What? This thing here, my Mouli. I think I showed you this before. This is my second or third Mouli. Anyway, I lost or broke the handle on the winder upper. And, was heartbroken. I bought another one. This is replacing one that I wore out, and then I bought another one, and the darn thing did not have this particular blade, which is almost exclusively what I use it for. This makes what my grandmother called gold dust. So I'm going to put this in here. Trying to, of course, do this one-handed. And this is where this goes. Oops. Come on. It's got to go in just so. So anyway, couldn't get it. Let's see if I can do that. There it goes. I just can't do anything one-handed. Okay, so couldn't get a replacement piece because nobody makes these old blades anymore or machines that'll fit the old blades. But look at this. This is really nice. This one is what I thought would work, like this one. But it's not the same. This makes, I don't know, silver dust, but definitely not gold dust. And these things are my doohickeys for, you know, the foley mill. I've got a few of those. See, two of these. And that, and some extra cookie press doodads that I'm going to give to Mom and Lisa. I got millions of them now. Anyway, so they're pretty neat. They were in the junk store one day, and I was just whining and complaining about this thing and not being able to use it, and I don't like using the food processor because it doesn't do as good a job, and the new Mouli didn't do as good a job, and blah, blah, blah. And I look up, and hanging in a plastic bag on a wall rack, I see these blades and a brand new handle. Hungry tried fixing it a million times, but every time you went through, like, what I'm going to use it for, it just didn't do a good job. I know, you don't put your Cuisinart blades in a blade box. You put them in a holder. Well, I have so many blades. I have every blade made for the Cuisinart that there's no room in the holder. Anyway, let me show you what I'm going to do with this. Okay, that's a hunk of Parmesan. Parmigiano Reggiano. Or gold dust bar. Gold bar. Anyway, my grandfather had a machine that made pretty much the same results as this. I don't know. Can you see? Probably not. But anyway, just wind it up. It goes smooth as glass. And look. Gold dust. Or angel hair. I know my grandfather, Monday morning, would sit at the kitchen table, which is my grandmother's kitchen table, was about 24 people could fit there, maybe 30 if you squished in some little kids. But he would grind the cheese for the week. because we'd be wiped out by Sunday. You know, in that neighborhood, all the Italians in Sicilian, they all had pasta on Sunday. You could have a ham or a turkey or a roast beef, but you always had gravy and you always had some kind of pasta and you always had the soup. What is the soup? Well, it's Italian wedding soup, but people today make it much differently than we did when I was a kid. Back in the olden days, it was a very fine and kind of brothy couple of meatballs. My mom, my great-grandmom, my grandmom, and my mom, and all my aunts all made these croutons. I'll make them for you someday. And, you know, very few vegetables. It was not a thick, hearty meal. It was soup to nuts kind of soup, because you have a lot of courses. But anyway, it always had gold dust. This is more like angel hair because it's not as short as what my grandmother used, because my grandfather had a big giant deli-sized electric grinder-upper. Okay, so that's all I wanted to show you. My Mouli. Look at that. Shaggy. Lovely.